Xin trình quỳ. Xin trình lục bì nhà.
Thank you, Mr. President. Just a correction to what I told you before the break. I looked at three different maps last night. I think the Cambodia roadmap that has the whole country, you can't actually see the name, but on Dan you can see the highway. But there is a map in evidence of Takao province, which is E3/10638. That is a map for the province with the, in which you can see
Thank you, Mr. President. Mr. Witness, before the break, we were speaking about the transportation of Vietnamese military uniforms. Do you recall seeing any Vietnamese people at the scene where
these weapons were put in the GC truck?
Did you hear anyone speak Vietnamese when the military uniforms were put in the truck? Let me see if I could assist you a bit.
Mr.
President, I will be referring again the transcript of the film footage that Robert Lemkin had with
Todd.
And just to be complete, I will be speaking about a Vietnamese person with the name Hay So. In his testimony before the Supreme Court chamber, knowing Hay So. However, in his when he was speaking with Robert Lemkin, described Hay So very extensively. I will be referring, Mr. President, to E3/10665, English ERN 01156805 and 806, Khmer 01168451 and 52. Mr. Witness, Hum or Todd speaks extensively about a very close friend of Dan Nguyen named Hay So. He talks extensively about who Hay So was, but let me describe him for you, and maybe it's someone that you recognize. He was Vietnamese, spoke Khmer. His color was a bit whiter than the interviewer. He was rather tall, around 1.7 meters, crew-cut hair. Did you know or did you ever see a Vietnamese person called Hay So?
Look, that look in JP, chun chip Vietnam, and that chumo Hay So, look a Hay So, nít thế.
Sạc sĩ công tan ảo chlái, xung chí lưu bình nhá.
A objection to using this part of this transcript. This is an enormous problem with the interviews that were conducted by Mr. Lemkin, which is that he or Tet Sambat were constantly reading confessions to the witnesses and then having them repeat that material. And if you look at the pages cited by counsel, it starts by indicating that a confession had just been read describing this person. So there is an issue here.
No issue whatsoever, Mr. President. It is indeed, there is mention of Hay So. However, Hay So was in S21. He is a high-ranking communist cadre from Vietnam. But what is important is that Tote or Ham offers information that he had himself about Hay So. He knew that Hay So was married to a woman from a poor ethnic minority, all kinds of details. So there is no relation whatsoever with any confession. So I really have no idea what the prosecution is talking about.
Well, let me make it clear what I'm talking about. At the start of this, these questions about Hay So, you'll see, I just saw his confession. I assume that this was either Nim or someone else's confession that you gave me and saw Hay So. So what is not clear in the ensuing questions is what information has come from him being provided this confession to read and what is information he knows himself. This is a repeated problem throughout these interviews that Lemkin conducted.
That is really not the case. He says that he knew Hay So personally, he says that Hay So was a close friend to Ru Nim, he describes him. The mere fact that someone is mentioned in a confession doesn't mean that we cannot ask questions if one or whoever is mentioned in a confession doesn't mean that we cannot ask any questions about that would be absurd. So it's clear from the record, clear from his interview with Lemkin that he knew him so personally, and what I want to establish is having read out the description, whether he remembers seeing Hay So either at the handing over of the military force or somewhere else.
Sorry, do you want to make is the use of this document restricted to the description, or do you want to make further use of it?
No, I only want to know if he knows Hay So, and if he does, then that's fine, and I don't have to give the description. If I give his description, maybe that is someone he knew at the time, or someone who might have been present when those uniforms were given. So just a physical description, and whether he knows Hay So. Mr. Witness, do you know Hay So, Vietnamese revolutionary who was a close friend of Dan Nim and who meets the description I just gave you?
Oh, no.
No problem. One last question before I move to your arrest and your interrogation there is evidence to suggest that many people within the Revolutionary Army of Kampuchea considered the Vietnamese arch-enemy. As a matter of fact, this very trial chamber that before you are testifying now has adjudicated that there was a war going on between the liberation April 75 and 79 between Cambodia and Vietnam. Didn't you think it was very strange and unusual for Thanh Niên and others to go collect military
uniforms
from a country that Cambodia was at war with?
មក ពី វៀតណាម នោះ នៅ ពេល ដែល កម្ពុជា និង វៀតណាម កំពុង តែ មាន ចំនួន ជាមួយ នឹង គ្នា
លោក សាស្ត្រី កុំ អត់ តាន់ ឆ្លើយ សូម អញ្ជើញ លោក ប្រញ្ញា
Yes, first of all, he's misstating. The witness states in his interview that there was no conflict or fighting going on at the time. Second, he's asking for an opinion, a conclusion from the witness rather than factual evidence.
Undisputed that the chamber said there was a war going on, an armed conflict. So that is so far undisputed. Mr. Witness, do you remember thinking that it was very unusual to collect Vietnamese uniforms from a country was at war with
And now this is a leading question. He's putting words and thoughts into the witness's mind rather than asking him another question.
After so many questions, I think this is a perfectly appropriate question. Were you not very surprised at what was going on?
This is actually really an opinion, but I think the question, did you consider it unusual? And now you can go ahead.
Did you consider it unusual? Highly unusual to collect military uniforms from Vietnam. Let me see if I can get an answer from you in a different way, from a different angle. Mr. Witness, is it correct that after Nguyen was arrested, you were also arrested and then sent to Battambang City, where you were questioned, questioned before you were ultimately sent to Koh Kao prison? And what do you remember about your questioning in Koh Kao prison? What did the interrogators ask you?
នេះសួរទៅនោះសួរថាយើងទៅប្រាវាប្រមាណឆ្នាំតាដឹងខ្ញុំថាខ្ញុំដឹងទេខ្ញុំដឹងអីផងយកការពីគាត់ចោះដឹងរឿងចែកចោះដឹង
Do you remember other questions they asked
you? Mày, lục miền trăm sầm nuốt đất tây tiết khi xua lục tha đường lệch đá.
Mr. Witness, do you remember any other questions that interrogators asked
you?
ที่สู้ทางนักสายยูนมันจับให้ไปย้ำช็อตสลับปีดองใบดองไงปีดองใบดองวันนี้จะดักยามีก็ขอเป็น
Let me read to you what you said to the interviewers.
E3/9581 question and answer 41.
Let me start with question and answer 40. I was interrogated twice a day. There were two interrogators, but I did not know them. They asked me the same question.
Quote,
how many times did you guys go to Vietnam? End of quote. I said, I did not go to Vietnam. Then they said, quote, you guy is Tanim's messenger. I do not believe you. You guys definitely used to go to Vietnam. End of quote. Then they used an electric baton of handphone size to electrocute my neck until I fainted. Mr. Witness, do you recall that they repeatedly asked you about your trip to Vietnam to collect military
uniforms? Do you recall that they
Council is misstating what the witness's answer was here and trying to lead him. He was asked about going to Vietnam. There's nothing in here about military uniforms, so he shouldn't be injecting that into his question.
Was the same question asked several times or many times, and was the question, how many times did you guys go to Vietnam? What did they mean with the question, how many times did you guys go to Vietnam? In the answer that I just read out to you, you said that the interrogators told you that you are Tanim's messenger and that you definitely used to go to Vietnam. Did they tell you how they knew that? What the source of information was? Did they tell you why they thought you had gone to Vietnam? And that your position as Tanim's messenger had anything to do with
that?
Nhưng mà đăng khó nó để dùng để tha thế nó cầu như thế bây giờ cái như sai cái chớp chớp thôi chớp
Did they ask you about those
Vietnamese
military uniforms you just described? Ai sẵn than
Việt Nam bộ khiêu nâng thế cái miền xu bị chụm lạch như thế?
So was it only the question why you went to Vietnam with Tan Ninh? Was that the only question?
Cái su tại thà hai đã vậy ban chỉ anh tàu Việt Nam chỉ mùi tại nhâm cái su tại sầm nuôi nâng tê rứ.
Mặt su không? Su tầm đo mặt đo nó.
But you're on, is it my should be my understanding that you were interrogated for twice two days
and you were also beaten and electrocuted and you said
and was it that the only question or what
exactly I mean, I understand it's difficult to live that interrogation but I'd be very grateful if you could try và xong lục chi diêm chạy tới nâng xong lục nhằm đoàn tiền mới
mà thăm trên nô nâng thả thành nhóm hàng dũ nhóm đăng tế đừng bị bánh nhóm đăng nhóm tàu chậm cất một bàn tàu nó nhằm nào tàu cả phía tiệt cất nữa con hào tàu tàu
But you just told us that you
went
with
Council
shouldn't mistake the record. The evidence was he went to Phnom Penh. There's no evidence that
Tan
had been to Vietnam at any time.
He went
to the Vietnamese border. That's his testimony.
To pick up military uniforms and pin them on the mountain.
But Mr. President, let me move on. I only have 15-20 more minutes. Mr. Witness, you were
Lục sạc sấy, lục cứ chỉ còn cà phê, rồi bỏ tình nhâm, lục chỉ nạ bạc bỏ chùn con.
Did you ever hear him speak?
Ta lục lọc đàn lưu tình nhâm, nì dây nụ khăn nông lan, rưu nụ khăn krau, nụ khăn nông vẹn, nụ bài nà môi đấy, lục đàn lưu tình nhâm, nì dây thế.
Còn nhâm mặt đài tôi chậm vật màn đấy không? Kìa nè, tìm mũi là cái chậm. Nhưng mà lâu chắc chắn là chắc chắn
I understand, but did you ever
hear
his voice? Did you ever hear him speak? Did you ever hear him speak?
Did you hear from others, his colleagues,
about the things
that Tan Ninh
said during meetings or political
sessions? Did you ever hear him speak?
Ngon rồi, làm đai prap với phóng, đai lưu cần chia với phóng.
Did you ever hear that Tan Ninh
Mê tử vị ta lục thu lọc lưu tử nhiễm
was trying to start a rebellion against
Pol Pot đó có rung đáy này chứ mùi nâng sao phơm và chăng chứ mùi nâng Pol Pot đáy được tế.
Ngọt, đà lưu hả?
Um, Mr. Witness, that same person we spoke about earlier, talked about storage of weapons for rebellion. Put before you what he said in his interview with on English ERN 0156801, Khmer 0116842, and a bit further. Hum or Toad told this filmmaker that had told him that he was no longer in Pol Pot's party, that Runyam was trying to gather forces and would resist against Pol Pot together with Saopin, and that Runyam started to form his own party at the time that Hum accompanied Nim to the wedding with Saopin. Let me see if I can try it differently, Mr. Witness.
Move away from
Let me put before you what another relatively low-ranking question and answer 30. He talks about the accusation of the Northwest being affiliated with the Viet Minh Khmer Rouge and the East Zone Committee Chief Saopin. And then he says, and I quote, these two zones, Like I said, this was a low-ranking Northwest
Khmer.
I spoke quite lengthy about British filmmaker Lemkin. Of course, I should also mention his colleague, the Cambodian Thet Sambat. And recently, in an interview Lemkin gave
សេចក្តីទៅជាមួយនឹងអ្នកសាស្ត្រឈ្មោះ George Rai មកពីកាសែតកម្ពុជាដេលីគាត់បាននិយាយអំពី secret civil war going on.
Yes, we didn't get any document reference
E3.
It was a very recent article in the Cambodia Daily.
Cambodia Daily
that
changed
site document E416.1.2 and the English ERN is 0129-8489.
So,
yes, English ERN 0129-8489, it is referenced as E416.1.2. So, Mr. Witness, was there a secret civil war?
Sorry, is this admitted or not?
Between on the one hand the northwest zone and the east zone, and on the other hand You didn't know, or you haven't heard. That I understand. My question is, did you observe internal rebellion going on in the northwest? Let me see if I can try it differently. Storage in warehouses of rice, fish, there are Northwest Zone cadres who speak about
instructing his subordinates to start a psychological war in the Northwest.
I just asked that if counsel is going to confront the witness with this material that he identified the material so we can all see what exactly the sources are.
Yes, certainly. It's another interview that British filmmaker had with Northwest Zone cadres. F2/4/3/6.2. It's witness referred to as witness 3, who talks about transporting economic equipment, like rice, fish, petrol, hammocks, guns, equipment and weapons.
ឧបករណ៍របស់របរផ្សេងៗទៀតយកទៅលាក់ទុកដើម្បីធ្វើការបាក់បោក
I believe this was one of the transcripts that the court rejected in the ruling on the J-87-4 request. Unless I'm wrong about that, it's highly improper for counsel to be trying to read from something that this court has rejected.
Yes, I was indeed reading from a document that was forbidden, be so humble to remark. You're withholding crucial evidence.
Je pense que la remarque est tout à fait déplacée.
Mà cái lực lượng của Mê Tư Vĩ này cứ hù hại bề hay.
No, it isn't at all.
Mê Tư Vĩ mình hù hại thế.
Crucial evidence for the defense.
That's why I'm referring to.
Sum lúc xua sum ngua tới xã sấy.
Yes, and thank you for cutting off my microphone at the suggestion of Judge Levin, Mr. President. An additional question, Mr. Witness, did you ever hear about Chan Chakrai or Von Vet being present at meetings where Tan Nim spoke?
Đăng tha Chan Chakrai. Mean what to mean what when Chan Chakrai and I mean what to mean no pill that the Yum Puchum High Lang Yay no
day.
I'm almost done, but for the record, Mr. President, the fact that Von Vet was present at this meeting where Tan Nim spoke about rebellion is also something we can find in Robert Lemkin's interviews, which are unfortunately not going to be admitted into evidence. Thank you.
Mr. President, the
let me start by saying that is not a fact.
That
is another great example of Lemkin using S-21 confessions in his interviews. So counsel to put that forward as a fact when it's been rejected by this court is just beyond the pale. Mr. Witness, I'll be asking you some questions on behalf of the prosecution. Let me go back, ask some more questions about your background. You stated that you joined the revolution in 1972. How old were you at that time? Your according to your records of interview, you were born on the 10th of November 1960, which would mean you would have been 12 years old. Is 1960 not your actual year of birth? You're not the first person in this country to have some problem with their
In answer to your first CIA interview,
1981, you state, let me read I joined the Khmer Revolution, Khmer Rouge Revolution in 1972. I voluntarily joined the revolution myself then. At first, I was assigned to work in the art section. Later on, I was assigned as a messenger for Tam Nim. And he delegated me to deliver letters to the military at Phnom Penh, Tibet Day, I was his courier for only 2 months because the work was too hard. Then I volunteered to join the army in 1974. Let me just ask you some follow-up questions on this. During this two-month period in 1973 or 1974, when you were working as a messenger for Tan Nim, where was Tan Nim located? Where was he based during those 2 months? Well, let me ask it to you this way. Where you identified locations where you would deliver letters to on behalf of Tan Nim. Where would you pick up those letters from him? Where did you work during those 2 months? Do you remember what district that was in? And continuing in the same answer to you say that after being the messenger for 2 months, you volunteered to join the army in 1974, and you say, quote, "I was assigned to spy on the Lon Nol soldiers' barracks." And the quote, which Lon Nol barracks were you assigned to spy on during this time period? And during this period, when you were part of the military, are you able to tell us what unit you were in, or what part of the Northwest Zone Army? So you were part of the sector military. Can you tell us which sector you were part of? And who was your commander during this time? Who was it that assigned you your tasks, for example, to go spy on these barracks?
Mm-hmm.
Mua sạch chai em, mua chai em.
Now I want to move to the time period between 17 April 1975 up until the time you were asked by Thanem to be his bodyguard. You state in answer 3 of the same interview, E3-9581, that you were living in Kong Hot between 17 April 1975 and 1976. Can you clarify what you were doing during that time period and what unit you were part of at that time?
I was in Kong Hot at that time.
So you continued to be in the sector military. What work did you perform as part of the sector military between 17 April 1975 and when you were assigned to work for Thanem in 1976? Do you remember when in 1976
assigned to be in the bodyguard?
Now turning to some questions about the time period you were working for Thanem as his bodyguard, and you were working at this a place, Ampol Prahong, that was very close to Prahong City, or Battambang town. Did you know a village that was maybe 1 or 2 kilometers south of Battambang, provincial town named Wat
Pho?
And can you tell us how far from Ampol Prahong is Wat Pho? How far apart are those two locations? Is Wat Pho, the village, close immediately south of Battambang provincial town?
During
the regime, did you know that
Nunchea,
the deputy secretary
of the party
was from Battambang. He was from Wat Phor. Did you know that?
លោកមានដឹងឯងមានដឹងថាលោកនួនជាដែលជាអនុលេខាបកហ្នឹងគាត់មកពីភូមិកោហ្នឹងឯងមកពីបាត់ដំបង
ខ្ញុំមិនដឹងទេបង
Did you ever hear Tanem talk about Nuon Chea?
តើលោកធ្លាប់ឮតញឹមនិយាយអំពីឈ្មោះនួនជាដែរឬទេ
ខ្ញុំតែនិយាយពួកខ្ញុំផងខ្ញុំមិនដាច់ទៅខ្លែងគាត់ទេនៅក្រៅផ្ទះគាត់ផ្សេងផ្សេងខ្ញុំមានការគាត់ហៅចូល
I want to ask you about something
Nunchea's
messenger.
ចំណុចមួយដែលនារីសារបស់នួនជានិងអ្នកបើកបររបស់នួនជាក៏ដូចជាកងការពារបានផ្ដល់សេចក្តីកម្មនៅចំពោះតុលាការយើងនៅថ្ងៃទី18មេសាឆ្នាំ
2012លោកធានីគឺឯកសារ E1/63.1
លោកបន្តិចរិតចុះថ្ងៃទី18មេសាឆ្នាំ2012នៅម៉ោង 15:22 ដល់ម៉ោង ញឹកញាប់ប៉ុណ្ណាដែរឆ្លើយ
It was not frequent probably once every 3 or 4 months
មួយដងក្នុងរយៈពេល3ទៅ4ខែ
Where is it that Nuon Chea would meet with Tan Nim
តើនួនជានឹងបានជួបជាមួយនឹងតាញឹមនៅកន្លែងណាដែរ
They met somewhere in a pagoda but I cannot recall the name គាត់ជួបនៅក្នុងវត្តមួយ
ខ្ញុំនឹកគោឈ្មោះវត្តនោះមិនឃើញទេ
Was it near Battambang provincial town?
តើវត្តនោះនៅជិតទីរួមខេត្តបាត់ដំបងមែនទេ?ឆ្លើយបាទវត្តនោះនៅជិតខេត្តបាត់ដំបងបញ្ចប់ការដកស្រង
់ My question to you Mr. Witness សំណួ
ររបស់ខ្ញុំលោកសាក់សី
Nuon Chea driver said that he
អ្នកបើកបររបស់នោះជាបានឆ្លើយថានួនជា
បានជួបតាញឹម
អាចជួបតាញឹមនៅក្នុងវត្តមួយនៅជិតទីរួមខេត្តបាត់ដំបង
That was used by Tanim for meetings with people such as Nuon Chea.
Squall chmua wat dal ta nyum na yok thoi che ti kanlai nam bai chuop chmuoy Nuon Chea dai ru te.
Wat nam men wat kuon ai pon nyum dang ka thoi sai mndang. Wat dang wat wat kuon. Phlo ta pnan thop sa lơ jeung. Pon mai ai dang te.
And the temple the pagoda in the Nuon Chea's home village
Wat Phor sat nok nong phum kamnao robos Nuon Chea nok Wat Phor
during the time you were working for Tanim
Wat ni ke mien ban prae prah che avai dae te no pe dae lok tveu ka chmuoy tanim nu
ខ្ញុំសោដឹងដែរ
do you know the pagoda the big pagoda that is right in the heart of Battambang provincial town
ធំណាស់វត្តហ្នឹងនៅកណ្ដាលទីរួមខេត្តបាត់ដំបងនៅចិត្តស្ទឹងគេហៅថាវត្តកណ្ដាលតើលោកស្គាល់ឈ្មោះវត្តនេះទេវត្តកណ្ដោវត្តកណ្ដល
អត
់ you've never I don't know if I'm perhaps I'm not pronouncing it correctly
ប្រហែលជាខ្ញុំអាចឈ្មោះវត្តនេះមិនច្បាស់ទៅក៏មិនដឹងតើលោកធ្លាប់ស្គាល់វត្តកណ្ដោទេវត្តនេះធំណាស់នៅជិតមាត់ស្ទឹងគឺនៅក្នុងទីរួមខេត្តបាត់ដំបងនោះតែម្ដង
Lúc sáng thấy vót này cứ mua hai thang vót còn đào.
Do you know that pagoda, Mr. Witness?
Sabrina, lúc sáng thấy mấy con vót này thấy vót còn đào.
Vót bao nhiêu đã đào không? Vì trống.
Mr. President, about to change to a different
subject.
ប្រធានខ្ញុំហៀបនឹងចូលទៅប្រធានបទថ្មីមួយទៀតហើយប៉ុន្តែមើលមកទៅដល់ពេលត្រូវឈប់សម្រាកហើយអរគុណលោកប្រធានណាឥឡូវដល់ពេលសម្រាកហើយអង្គវាប្រកាសផ្អាកកិច្ចដំណើរការសមនីតិវិធីសមនាការសម្រាប់ថ្ងៃនេះត្រឹមនេះហើយសមនាការនឹងលើកបន្តធ្វើនៅថ្ងៃស្អែកថ្ងៃពុធទី22ខែកញ្ញាឆ្នាំ2016ដែលចាប់ផ្ដើមពីម៉ោង9ព្រឹកទៅ សាវនាការនៅថ្ងៃស្អែកអង្គរងធ្វើសាវនាការស្ដាប់សុខីកម្មសាក់សី2 TCW 1306បន្តបញ្ចប់ហើយនឹងចាប់ផ្ដើមស្ដាប់សុខីកម្មដើមដឹងរដ្ឋបាលវិនិច្ឆ័យ 2 TCP 1962ពាក់ព័ន្ធ57ពាក់ព័ន្ធអង្គហេតុបទបញ្ជានៃការរៀបអាពាហ៍ពិពាហ៍សូមពិគីជ្រាបនឹងអញ្ជើញចូលរួមតាមពេលវេលាកំណត់បង្កប់អនុញ្ញាតមន្ត្រីឃុំឃាំងនាំខ្លួនជូនជាប់ចោតទាំងពីររូបលោកនួនជានិងលោកខៀវសំផនត្រឡប់ទៅកាន់មន្ត្រីឃុំឃាំងន 2006 ឲ្យបានមុនម៉ោង 9 ព្រឹកអញ្ជើញសម្រាប់